students, in this video we are going to study properties of vector addition and we are going to solve some questions based on vector addition. So first let's solve some questions and then we will study the properties. So here the question given is a triangle PQR is given. PQ bar is given as A bar, PR bar is given as B bar, PS bar is C bar, SQ bar is minus D bar and SR bar is D bar, because both have opposite directions. That means S is midpoint of QR. Since here we have D bar and minus D bar, so they are having equal magnitude but opposite directions, that's why they are negative of each other. Okay, so we have to find out C bar and D bar in terms of A bar and B bar. So what we have given is PQ bar is given and PR bar is given. So first let's find out QR bar. So by vector addition of by triangle law of addition, what we have is PQ bar plus QR bar equal to PR bar, as we have the direction PQ bar and PR bar. So PQ bar plus QR bar is PR bar. So PQ bar is A bar. Now we want to find out QR bar and PR bar is given B bar. So QR bar becomes B bar minus A bar. Okay, so that is QR bar. But this SR bar is half of QR bar, as S is midpoint. Since S is midpoint of QR bar, S is midpoint of line segment QR, therefore SR bar, that is D bar, is equal to half QR bar, and QR bar is B bar minus A bar, so D bar becomes half B bar minus A bar. Now let's find out C bar. So in the triangle PSR, we have the direction from P to S, then S to R. So we are going from P to S, then S to R. That means we are traveling from P to R. So in triangle PSR, by triangle law of addition, it is PS bar plus SR bar equal to PR bar. Now we have PS bar as C bar, SR bar is D bar and PR bar is B bar. Okay, so to find C bar becomes now B bar minus D bar, and we have D bar as half of B bar minus A bar. So let's substitute for D bar. So that is half of B bar minus A bar. So this becomes 2 B bar minus bracket B bar minus A bar divided by 2. So that is 2 B bar minus B bar minus minus plus A bar divided by 2. So 2 B bar minus B bar is B bar. So this becomes A bar plus B bar divided by 2. So we have C bar and D bar in terms of A bar and B bar. Now consider this question. In a triangle PQR, PQ bar equal to 2A bar, QR bar equal to 2B bar, midpoint of PR is M, find the following vectors in terms of A bar and B bar. So the question asked is about PR bar, PM bar and QM bar. First, let's draw the diagram. So a triangle is given, so let this be triangle PQR. So this is triangle PQR. Now PQ bar is given, PQ bar is 2A bar. Next is QR bar is given, so this is QR bar, which is 2B bar. Now midpoint of PR is given, so midpoint of PR is M, so this is midpoint of PR. That means PM equal to MR. Find the following vectors in terms of A bar and B bar. So first of all, PR bar is asked. Now PQ bar plus QR bar equal to PR bar, as we have for direction from P to Q and direction from Q to R. So by triangle law of addition, PQ bar plus QR bar equal to PR bar. Therefore, PR bar is equal to PQ bar, but PQ bar is 2A bar plus QR bar, which is 2B bar. So this is answer of first question. PR bar is 2A bar plus 2B bar. Now to find PM bar. PM bar, M is midpoint of PR. So PM bar is equal to half PR bar. Since the direction is same, but magnitude is half of PR bar. But already we have PR bar as 2A bar plus 2B bar. So substituting that, it is half 2A bar plus 2B bar. So taking 2 common and cancelling, we get PM bar as A bar plus B bar. Next is QM bar. Now QM bar is like this. Consider the triangle P to Q, Q to M, so P to M. And we already have PM bar here. So from triangle PQM, PQ bar plus QM bar equal to PM bar. Okay. To find QM bar now, QM bar becomes PM bar minus PQ bar. Now let's substitute these vectors. PM bar is A bar plus B bar minus PQ bar. PQ bar is 2A bar. So this becomes B bar minus A bar. See, it's really very simple using triangle law of addition. Next question is, in a pentagon ABCDE, show that AB bar plus AE bar plus BC bar plus DC bar plus AD bar equal to 2AC bar. Let's solve this without using a diagram. So by triangle law of addition, what we have is PQ bar plus QR bar is equal to PR bar. See, to use triangle law of addition, what we need is final point of first vector should be initial point of second vector. So to add this, just we don't write that Q. So we have PQ bar plus QR bar as PR bar. We write this final point and this terminal point R bar, and we write it as PR bar. So we cancel this common point like that, PR bar. So to find this addition and to prove that it is 2AC bar, so what we need is AC bar plus AC bar. So let's find out those vectors such that final point of the first vector should be initial point of second vector. You can see here we have AB bar plus BC bar. So here the final point is B and here the initial point is B. So let's write AB bar and BC bar together, so that using triangle law of addition, we can add these two vectors. So we have written AB bar and BC bar. Now let's write the remaining vectors together. So remaining vectors are AE bar, then we have DC bar and AD bar. So after AE bar, let's write AD bar. Now you can understand the reason why, because final point of this vector is initial point of this vector, okay? And the remaining vector is DC bar. See, here also we have final point of this vector as initial point of this vector. So we can add this. So AB bar plus BC bar is now AC bar. So to prove that it is 2AC bar, we already have 1AC bar. And adding these two vectors now, the addition is AD bar plus DC bar as it is. Again, add these two vectors. Now D is common here. So we have AC bar plus AD bar plus DC bar is also AC bar. So that's how we get 2AC bar. So without using the diagram, only using the triangle law of addition, we can prove that it is 2AC bar. Now next question is, a regular hexagon is given ABCDEF. Show that AB bar plus AC bar plus AD bar plus AE bar plus AF bar equal to 6AO bar, where O is the center of the hexagon. So here the hexagon is given as ABCDEF. Regular hexagon means it has six sides and all the sides are equal. So to prove that AB bar, so we need AB bar, then we want AC bar. So let's draw AC bar. So this is AC bar, then AD bar. So this is AD bar, AE bar and AF bar. So AE bar and AF bar. So this addition we have to prove that it is a 6 AO bar where O is center of the regular hexagon. So now we know how to use triangle law of addition. Now using parallelogram law of addition, we are going to prove this. So consider this. So let's join F and D. Okay. Now consider ACDF. So ACDF is a parallelogram. As it is a regular hexagon, AF and DC are parallel. AC and DF are also parallel. So here we have ACDF as a parallelogram, as it is a rectangle. So rectangle is always a parallelogram, and AC bar and AF bar are adjacent sides of the parallelogram. So what is parallelogram law of addition? Parallelogram law of addition is, if this is ABCD, then we have AB bar plus AD bar equal to AC bar, or BC bar plus BA bar equal to BD bar. Similarly, we can write CB bar plus CD bar equal to CA bar. So every time I start with the same initial point, I write the sum of the adjacent sides, and the resultant is the diagonal with the same initial point. DA bar plus DC bar equal to DB bar. Okay. Now let's consider this rectangle ACDF. So in ACDF, if we take initial point as A, then the adjacent sides are AC bar and AF bar, and the resultant is the diagonal with the same initial point, that is AD bar. So we have first equation as AC bar plus AF bar equal to AD bar, where we are considering rectangle ACDF. Okay. Now let's consider another rectangle. Now let's join B and D. So if we join B and D, again we have ABDE as a rectangle. So ABDE is a rectangle. So in rectangle ABDE, remember we have to start with A only, as here initial point is A. So in ABDE, consider this rectangle in ABDE. Now the adjacent sides with initial point A are AB bar and AE bar, and diagonal is the same resultant. That therefore AB bar plus AE bar equal to AD bar. Okay. So we have AC bar plus AF bar, AC bar plus AF bar equal to AD bar, and AB bar plus AE bar, AB bar plus AE bar equal to AD bar. So rearranging these terms, given left side is AB bar plus AC bar plus AD bar plus AE bar plus AF bar. Let's write it as AB bar plus AE bar plus AD bar as it is, and AC bar plus AF bar. So from above two equations, this is AD bar, and this bracket is also AD bar. So equal to 3 AD bar. But AD bar and AO bar, let's find out the relation. AD is a diameter of this circle and AO is radius.
So AD bar is twice AO bar because they have same direction, but length of AD is twice that of length AO. So therefore this is 2 AO bar. So this becomes 6 AO bar, which is equal to right hand side. Now let's study properties of vector addition. First property is commutative property. Vector addition is commutative. Commutative means or in which order we are adding the vectors, that is not important. So A bar plus B bar equal to B bar plus A bar. So here we have interchange A bar and B bar in the right hand side. So irrespective of the order, we get the same addition. A bar plus B bar is same as B bar plus A bar. Let's see the proof. It's really very simple. Consider a parallelogram. So let this be a parallelogram. Let this be A bar and let this be B bar. So by equality of vectors, if we denote this by O, A and this by O, B and let this be C. So by equality of vectors, BC bar and OA bar are equal. So BC bar is also B bar. Similarly, OB bar and AC bar are equal. So OB bar is A bar, so AC bar is also A bar. Now consider triangle OBC. If we consider triangle OBC, then OB bar plus BC bar is OC bar, so that is A bar plus B bar, considering triangle OBC. And if we consider triangle OAC, then we have OA bar plus AC bar, that is equal to OC bar. But OA bar is B bar, so that is B bar plus A bar. So OC bar, considering this triangle, we have A bar plus B bar, and considering this triangle, it is B bar plus A bar. But since it is OC bar only, we have the equality. So that is commutative law. Second is associative law. Associative means, associative law is also true for vector addition. That is A bar plus B bar plus C bar is A bar plus B bar plus C bar. So in the left hand side we have first addition of A bar and B bar, and then we are adding C bar to it. Here we are adding B bar and C bar first, and then we are adding this sum to A bar. So still we have the equality. Let's see. So if we have OA bar as A bar, so let this be OA bar, A bar. AB bar is B bar and BC bar is C bar. Now why I am taking like this? Because since we have here addition of A bar and B bar, so final point of A bar is initial point of B bar. Similarly, for to add B bar and C bar, final point of B bar, I have taken it as initial point of C bar. So that's why I have taken like this. Now we have write first of all left hand side. Now left hand side is A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Now what is A bar? A bar is OA bar, B bar is AB bar, plus C bar is BC bar. Now OA bar plus AB bar is OB bar by triangle law of addition. So this becomes OB bar plus BC bar. Now OB bar plus BC bar will be OC bar. So in the left hand side, simplifying it, we get OC bar. Now let's write right hand side. Right hand side is A bar plus B bar plus C bar. A bar is OA bar, B bar is AB bar, and C bar is BC bar. So first of all, we have to solve the bracket. So bracket is AB bar plus BC bar. So AB bar plus BC bar, that will be AC bar. So this is AC bar, OA bar as it is. Now OA bar plus AC bar. So O to A to C means O to C. So we get OC bar. So from equation number 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, left and right side are equal. That means associative law holds good for vector addition. So vector addition is commutative as well as associative. Next is A bar plus 0 bar equal to 0 bar plus A bar equal to A bar. So 0 bar is known as additive identity of vector addition. Okay, so it's really simple. A bar plus 0 bar is 0 bar plus A bar equal to A bar. Next one is A bar plus minus A bar is equal to 0 bar. So this is known as additive inverse. So A bar minus A bar it's really very obvious that it is a 0 bar. It's not 0, it is 0 bar. Since it is vector addition, the addition is a vector, not 0, it should be 0 bar. Next is M into A bar plus B bar, that is a scalar multiplication. So we have it as M A bar plus M B bar. Similarly, M plus N into A bar is M A bar plus N A bar. So what is the difference here? Here we have addition of vectors and we are multiplying that sum by a scalar. And here these both are scalars and we have only one vector. So that is distributivity. M A bar plus N A bar. Okay. Next definition is of that of position vector of a point. If A is any point in the plane and O is any fixed point, then we take OA bar as A bar and A bar is known as position vector of A. So we can take any fixed point and we can take the position vector. Okay. Now if we have A and B two points in the plane and if A bar and B bar are their position vector, then OA bar is A bar, and if this is point B and its position vector is B bar, then OB bar is B bar. Now let's join A and B and let's draw the vector AB bar. So now we can see here we have O to A and A to B direction. So OA bar plus AB bar is OB bar. So OA bar plus AB bar equal to OB bar. So A bar plus AB bar equal to B bar. Therefore, we get AB bar as B bar minus A bar. So it's really very important. AB bar is B bar minus A bar. B bar means what? It is position vector of the final point minus position vector of initial point. So if it is PQ bar, so what we get is Q bar minus P bar. If it is MN bar, we get N bar minus M bar. Okay, so using this position vector, sometimes we can solve the problem very easily. So for example, let's solve one question based on this. If say D is a midpoint, of AB and E is midpoint of CD, show that AC bar plus BD bar equal to 2DE bar. Okay, let's solve this question using this position vector. So let A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar be position vectors of the points A, B, C and D. So we are taking A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar. And we have point E also. So let's take E bar also. Position vector of points A, B, C, D, E. But before that, if it is midpoint, what we get? Let's see. If we take MN as a line segment and P is midpoint of it, then let's write P bar in terms of M bar and M bar. So let M bar and N bar be position vectors of point M and N respectively. And let P bar be position vector of point P. Now since it is midpoint, what we have is MP bar is same as PN bar. Why? Because they have same direction and equal length as it is midpoint. So MP equal to PN and direction is same. So by the equality, what we have is MP bar equal to PN bar. Now using this relation, AB bar is B bar minus A bar, we can write this as P bar minus M bar and PN bar will be now N bar minus P bar. So let's transfer this P bar to left hand side. So we get p bar plus p bar equal to, and transferring m bar to right hand side, n bar plus m bar. So we have 2 p bar is equal to m bar plus n bar. So here I have changed the order because it is commutative. Commutative law holds good for vectors. So we can write n bar plus m bar as m bar plus n bar. So we get p bar as m bar plus n bar upon 2. So this is known as midpoint formula. As in the case of coordinate geometry, we have seen that if xy is midpoint of the points, line segment joining the points x1, y1 and x2, y2, then we write it as x1 plus x2 upon 2, and y coordinate of the midpoint is y1 plus y2 upon 2. Similarly here, if p is midpoint of the line segment p, mn, then p bar is add this position vectors and divide by 2, m bar plus n bar upon 2. Okay, let's use this formula to prove this equality. Now what is given is d is midpoint of AB. Now since d is midpoint of AB, we have d bar equal to a bar plus b bar upon 2 by this formula. As d is midpoint, its position vector is sum of the position vectors of these points divided by 2. Similarly, e is midpoint of CD. So e is midpoint of CD, that means position vector of e, that is e bar, is sum of the position vectors of these two points. So that will be c bar plus d bar upon 2. Okay, now let's write the left hand side. Now the left hand side is ac bar plus bd bar. So we get this as c bar minus a bar plus bd bar is now d bar minus b bar. So we can write this as c bar plus d bar. Now these two vectors, they have negative sign. So let's take that common. So taking minus sign common, in the bracket we get a bar plus b bar. Okay. Now c bar plus d bar, see this equality. A bar is c bar plus d bar upon 2. So if we cross multiply, we get c bar plus d bar as 2 e bar. So we can write this as 2 e bar minus a bar plus b bar is 2 d bar. So we can write this as 2 d bar. So taking 2 common, we get a bar minus d bar, and that will be 2 de bar. De bar is a bar minus d bar, and that is our right hand side. Okay, see, using position vectors and without using the diagram, it's really very simple to prove the equality. In the next video, we will be solving more questions and we will be studying more theory. Okay. See you in the next video.